Hey, good morning, Alton and Elizabeth, Quarantine Kitchen, morning edition, a special morning edition because we are going to watch the, just a little bit of the Good Eats Marathon on Science Channel, which is leading up to the premiere of Good Eats Reloaded, the new season on Cooking Channel. So we're kind of, we just got up. I'm not gonna lie, we had a late.
You can blame Science Channel for the AM.
Blame Science Channel for this obscenely early.
That's not that.
Look, if we were having to go to the office to work, it would seem so early. So here's what happens every morning. I juice celery. Elizabeth likes celery juice. Here's the juicing situation there, and there you can see that. That's not an advertisement for Omega Juicers. We really do like Omega Juicers. And what do you make it?
My turmeric tamer.
A turmeric tamer? It sounds like a cocktail, but it's too early. What goes? Is this your smoothie that you make?
You know what I mean.
Yeah, I've never seen you do this part. I've never seen you heat up hemp. No.
Well, it's chilly. It's like fall out there somehow.
It is cold in Atlanta.
Yeah, I just walked the dogs and I got cold.
Are you gonna do that without the hand guard? It's okay. We don't have a hand guard.
No,
we don't have a hand guard. So. Okay, I'm gonna keep juicing celery. Be careful. I've never operated a machine like that this early in the day. Oh, holy crap! I haven't had coffee yet. So I'm going to put the juice on pause for a second, make sure. Okay, I've got my electric kettle going for 207 degrees. I need my cup. So ginger and turmeric into?
Hemp milk and maple syrup.
Maple syrup.
And I'll do a black pepper because black pepper activates the turmeric.
For the immunity part?
Yeah.
Coffee activates my immunity. So I'm going over to the coffee grinder. You know, the number one thing about getting a good cup of coffee in the morning is to grind your own beans. I own a bunch of coffee equipment, but the only thing that I really have to have is this big grinder situation that I've got right here. And I grind about 30 grams into this little cup here. I do this every morning. Some days I used to, like for days and years, I made espresso every morning, but now I've gone kind of pour over. How are you guys doing this morning? Everybody all right? Kind of loud. I was looking for 30 grams. We're not going to be as witty as we are at nighttime. It's not that we're not morning people. We're just
kind of
slow.
I refuse
to be funny. You can't refuse to be funny. Somebody here has got to be funny. That's what people are watching. Scavagale can be funny. Scavagale?
Yeah.
Scavagale's now trying to eat all of Franny's food, but Franny finished his food. So I'll set this up right here. I'll get back to your juice in a second, sweetheart. I'm not gonna forget your juice. I have to get this going. So I like a Chemex.
You didn't used to.
I didn't. She turned me on to the Chemex. I used to be kind of like, that's way too crunchy granola hippie crap. And then she started making me coffee in Chemex, and I started like really digging Chemex. Just to pour over, Rick. You can use anything you want. And I do use a scale. I weigh my water more than the coffee because I know that this is 30 grams. At least I'm going to bet that. Let's see how close I got. I'll tear the pot and see what we'll put in the coffee. Okay, 29 grams. That's pretty good. I mean, for morning. That's good. So I have my water. I'm gonna bloom the coffee. How are you doing? Are you good? You're good. You're whisking your elixir. We don't have long. What time is it? What? We have a dying insect on the stove?
It's like a flying, it's one of these things.
Oh, I got it. I have to take this out. Just a second.
We had the doors open all yesterday because it was beautiful.
I want it noted that I did not kill the flying creature on live YouTube. Okay, so I have my 29, this is a horrible view, isn't it? My 29 grams of coffee. I'm gonna bloom that.
29
grams was 13 grams. It was a Sean Kim movie. That was the weight of the soul or something like that. So I'm gonna bloom my coffee. I do this every morning. And this is to make it more receptive to the water for the actual brewing process. This is all going to be in our Good Eats coffee reload here coming up soon. But I do about 60 grams of water, hot water. This is 207 degrees. And I just let that sit for about 45 seconds. And what that does is it lets a lot of CO2 out of the grounds so that the brew water will be more easily received, shall we say. So I'm going to put my electric kettle back on. Then I'm just going to let this sit for a minute. Scabigail, checking out things this morning. Francis, it's Francis Luther. Hey, buddy, do you want to play with the ball? No, you don't want to play with the ball. Have you gotten your juicing done?
Yes. Are you okay over here?
You're good. Okay, so then I'm going to get back to my coffee because that's the important part. The show starts in, I don't know what time it is because I can't tell when this thing's on. 7:51. So we've got a few minutes.
9 minutes.
Hope you had a good night, everybody. Am I going to drink out of a mug or a glass this morning? This is a big decision for me. So now I've waited about 45 seconds. My grounds have bloomed. All right, they look like this.
Why is it called blooming?
Like a blooming onion? Like a blooming onion. We're not at Outback Steakhouse. The grounds kind of open up. And they spread apart from each other because the CO2 gas pushes them apart. So now I'm going to add 200 grams of water. The hipster pour over method. I used to like roll my eyes at this stuff. It's like, oh my God, this is just going to be a cup of coffee. And then the truth is it's pretty good. So 200, I overshot a little bit. I'm going to let that take a second, put the water back on. You guys have been asking us, by the way, about this weird piece of furniture that makes up our kitchen. We call it the Beast. It's actually a factory, some piece of factory.
German
factory kind of stuff. But you guys have been asking
like
about this stuff. It was used for some kind of like parts thing. So it's a bin that we have filled with, well, I have filled with crap mostly.
Wow.
Well, everybody's got one of these. It's usually a drawer, sweetheart. Ours is a bin, which makes it cooler. Seltzer chargers, matches, a lot of matches. Anyway, it has two of them. It has one on the other end.
I've sure never actually seen you use a seltzer machine. So.
Well, that's because we use the big carbonator thing. It uses the bigger tanks. Okay, there's my coffee is happening. I'm very, very happy to say. So now another 200 grams of water, and then I can have coffee, and then everything will be okay. I don't know, what time is it?
7:53.
What is your?
Three.
Okay. So we don't even know what episodes of Good Eats are coming on this Science Channel marathon.
It's a chance I've never seen it.
I'm hoping that it'll be a show that you haven't seen because when we met, that one over there had no idea what I even did for a living. I own my own car, so I think she was hopeful. He's at least employed, right? All right. I'm gonna drink out of a Gibraltar glass this morning, if I can find one. This is usually for cortados.
That smells really good.
What does? The coffee? The coffee's
solid.
Ooh.
He's a solid coffee maker, folks.
It's taken me a while though, but I do weigh the water. I weigh the grounds. I weigh the water, and so I know. That I know I'm gonna get basically 400 milliliters of coffee here. I don't need more than 400 milliliters of coffee.
I probably need more than I get.
Testy. What do you mean you what?
I quit drinking coffee, I noticed.
She quit drinking coffee. She's much smoother. 7:54. So, for those of you that don't actually get Science Channel, by the way, I'm told that a lot of the affiliates have added people on for free to things like Science Channel and Cooking Channel because they're not able to offer live sports during this time when there's not live sports. So if you think you don't get Cooking Channel or Science Channel, you should check because you actually might, even if you're not paying for it. So there's that.
Where's that strainer thing that you put?
She isn't
worried about running. You have the ginger in it.
Oh. Wait, yes, okay, hold on.
He hides things sometimes.
I don't know where to go. Here, whoop.
See, coffee is why. That was so natural.
Yeah, I learned that just then.
You should be lucky I'm wearing pants this morning.
Yes, we should all be lucky you're wearing pants.
Well, you had to be a smarty pants, didn't you?
It's early. We watched the Sweetie Wakiti live Instagram.
Well, we tried to watch his live Instagram, but the audio was even worse than our show. So we ended up just watching Thor Ragnarok anyway. Without the... Although we are very excited. Well, he is making another one. Love and Thunder.
Yeah, it seems to be. Yeah.
Okay, so there's what I have to have. Now see, I've gone and gotten my cup cold, so... Everybody should warm your mug or your drinking device before drinking your coffee, or it'll just sap the heat out of your coffee. I hate cold coffee, unless I'm drinking iced coffee, which I'm not doing. How's your elixir? Here's my elixir. You guys are kind of probably disappointed. You're thinking, oh, that empty hole's where the juicer lives, by the way. If you're looking at that, that's the cubby that the juicer lives. You're probably disappointed. You think, oh, we're going to get up in the morning and it'll be like Ree Drummond or Martha Stewart. You know, there'll already be a breakfast souffle in the oven.
No, I think we got up 15 minutes ago.
We got up 15 minutes ago.
But you were given very little heads up on
this. I had very little heads up, Science Channel. You call me on like Monday. So, hey. This is gonna happen.
That wasn't Monday. Monday would be like forever. No, it was like 2 days ago.
Time is folding and collapsing on itself. I can't tell what time is.
Oh my God,
this is cool. So I have my coffee now and I'm happy.
Here, try this. Super yummy.
All right, I'll try your elixir. So tell the nice people. Turmeric, hemp milk, ginger, black pepper.
And maple syrup.
And maple syrup. It's delicious.
Yeah.
It's better than my coffee.
No, it's not.
You're right.
Nothing's better than your coffee.
That's not true.
It's your first and last.
That's not true. That's not true. It's the most consistent relationship that I've had in my life is with coffee. The other thing that I like about the Chemex is you can park it on a low burner and it won't freak out. I hate cold coffee, so I'll put that on a super low flame.
Remember to take it off because we have been known to.
I have been known to drive away. We'll be like 20 minutes from home. I'm like, I'm pretty sure I left that burner on, and I come home, and it's not on. What time is it? How are we doing? Do we have to? I should turn off. It's 7:58. We should get ready on Science Channel, I think, is still airing something about Nazis. So it's the first time that a Good Eats episode has ever followed Nazis.
Is there not a Nazi cooking channel?
There's not a Nazi cooking channel. There's not a Nazi cooking channel. So here's another member of the family that you guys haven't met before. This is Mr. Puffy. This is Scabigail's friend. So like her best friend. And it is. They're still talking about Nazis. I don't know where the remote control is.
What's the fascination with Nazis? Why do these shows? I don't understand.
I don't know. I don't program things.
I'm opening up to discussion.
Well, I don't think nobody wants to discuss Nazis at like 8 in the morning.
Why exactly? Why is it on?
Well, I want to know why I can't hear anything.
For all the Nazi lovers?
I've lost the other remote. Well, that's what I'm saying I lost.
That's classic. That's right here in the chair. Right here.
Well,
look, it's Nazi Austria.
So we've got ourselves set up in our TV area to watch the Good Eats Marathon. It's our living room, by the way.
It's our
fan. It is a complete disaster. This is what, this is Wobbles, the badger. It's my work table for home quarantine. That's pretty bad. That's a plant. That's the bar. We don't actually usually keep these chairs here. This is just for so we can Dead Sea Scrolls, the Doomsday Prophecy.
Oh, see, that's cool. Their architecture is very cool. We're not allowed to say that.
But, I just don't think that...
Oh, God.
This is an old show. I don't even know which show they're showing. Hold on.
I'm skinny.
I was thinner than I am now.
I know.
Look, you guys can just turn and watch this on cooking. No, on Science Channel if you want to. It's the beginning of a marathon that's going to last until... Oh, this is a tempura show. I love this. Hold on. This is a puppet that was built by Lucky Yates, my friend, excellent puppeteer. I love this. Hold on a second. Yeah, my neck is real. The sound mix could be better on this. It's okay, Scabs. Scabs doesn't like it. The tempura monster.
She's okay, sweetheart.
See, she comes to me. Oh, I mean, look, she's here. Cole? That's Cole. That's the guy that actually edits, shoots and edits all of the pantry raid videos, if you've been watching those.
Is tempura really a monster? No, it is simply the pinnacle of the frying arts. It seems like a monster because doing it right can be so darn daunting. Even most Japanese cooks don't dare attempt it at home. When they want tempura, they go to a tempura restaurant.
That's true. They do.
You know, if we stand up and fight,
can you guys understand what it's saying? For those of you that don't have Science Channel, I want you to be able to hear this. Wearing a Breitling Aerospace, by the way, for the watch people. Yeah, I weighed about 165 pounds when I made that. I don't weigh that anymore. I wasn't happy. You lose weight and you think you're going to be happy. It doesn't always work that way.
Japanese cuisine, there are several forms of deep fried foods.
Sexy jacket, though.
One of which is a karamelake or a batter fried foods. Now, the most typical batter fried food is tempura, which is composed of lightly battered.
I don't know what year this is. Any of you guys know what year this is? I'm going to bet 2011. Do you want me to be that skinny again?
Establishment is tempura serious. The distance between Hollywood and patron will be as short as possible.
Well, I know getting you there will be painful.
As soon as it's, you know, blown off the inside of your mouth.
What we were supposed to say is, I'm perfect now.
You are perfect now.
I'm gonna go get more. Look, you guys can hang around if you want to. I'm just gonna get more coffee. I'll be right back.
I've never seen this. Is a Western import. I've never seen any of the shows. 1494, Spain, except the new ones, which are amazing. And this is really funny so far, so I'm excited. See, Scabs has gotten in the chair to watch. It's very funny. I like the music. It's a dance party over here.
Get your ass out of my chair. Get out of my chair.
Come here, lovey. Give me a sweet girl.
That's better. I can actually watch looking at the phone. It's kind of an anime looking thing. The mix is bad. I never knew that the mix was this bad. Yep, the mix is horrible.
Japan in 1587. But the
method, the music at the time, done by my longtime music associate, Patrick Belden, who we lost a couple of years ago.
Right, yeah. So we'll just take a couple of pieces back to the lab for analysis. Domo arigato.
Domo arigato.
Further examination of the sample reveals a thoroughly cooked base.
These things down under the TV are models of European transmission towers.
Well,
long story as to why we have those.
There is no outward sign of greasiness whatsoever.
They're very old. They're from the
tempura scares the tokes off so many cooks, as amazing forces are clearly at work. But monstrous? I think not. The way I see it, if we're going to be victorious over tempura, the food must be prepped perfectly. The oil must be carefully chosen and heated to an exact.
This is when we first started moving lights around on blackboards.
Tricky part.
Now we just use an overhead projector. It allows us to do it a lot easier.
But not greasy. That'll be a challenge. But
you all right, Scabs?
Prep the food. Traditionally, Tempura is a method for cooking vegetation.
Yeah, refrigerator's not that clean. You've seen it. Any of you that are fans of Quarantine Kitchen know damn well it doesn't look anything like that.
Flat leaf parsley, the wider the leaves, the better. Shrimp.
So this was obviously shot in the actual house. There were two Good Eats houses. This one was the second, or the longest, also known as the Brown House. It was never mine, I didn't own it, but you can tell that it's the actual house. Later we moved into a set, and you can tell that the back wall is actually a thing called a translite, basically a big flat backlit thing.
The kombucha squash and bamboo shoots, all highly prized.
No, I'm wrong.
Sweet potato.
Wrong. This is the final set. This is the last set. This is when our studio used to be down. We shot this in the hallway. We built the cellar in the hallway. We just lined the hall with fake brick. I was fatter when we shot in the original house. I can usually tell the year from the extra skin on my neck and the watch I'm wearing.
All right, listen up. Tempura cooks fast, so tempura cooks hot. And so
the problem with losing a lot of weight when you've been, you know, really kind of heavy
ratio.
Is
no problem with the beans.
You get Drew Carey face. It's difficult to live with.
You
get Drew Carey face. Your face never, like when Drew Carey lost all that weight, you look at him now and you're like, what happened to you? It's like it's creepier now because the skin.
I would call it Seth Rogen face.
Seth Rogen face? Oh, he did it too. But it didn't. And now he just looks boring.
He's still funny, but yeah.
Really? Because I wasn't funny when I was thin. I don't know that I'm funny now, but chubby is funnier than skinny. Unless you get really skinny.
More relatable.
And then you have to be like Laurel and Hardy.
Do that with a knife, you know.
Yeah, one of
the other. It would be hard.
It's hard to do both of those, though.
So, break out the mandolin. Thing, do you never grow weary of that gag? Because I, for one, think it was funny about 1.2 times. I speak, of course, of this.
You just used that. It's the same one. We're very cheap on this show.
With a fixed blade like this, but if it comes with a handguard, always make sure you utilize it. And this needs to be peeled.
That keeps me from having to do a lot of actual work.
Your mise en place done. Go ahead and wrap
it. Yeah, we need one of those.
So that you can kind
of we do need one of those. We need to be able to throw things up and have them just come down.
Oh, see? Did not know that. I'm learning things.
Shojinagi?
Shojinagi. Didn't know. Oh, God, commercials. I can't stand commercials.
She can't stand commercials. But you don't appreciate them. Look. I don't know how to use the
You're
mute.
You're sitting on the other one.
So here's the thing. If you don't watch commercials,
there is no TV.
There's unless you get a subscription. I mean, somebody's got to pay for stuff.
I understand. It's also why we have DVRs. Although I never watch TV much. It's fascinating.
What is?
That. I don't know. No, you're right about commercials. You get mad.
This
at
is fascinating. Now. This appears to be about the Devil's Triangle, Bermuda Triangle, which was operated by Nazis.
I was really
so there's
afraid.
The tie back.
Yeah, when I was a little girl, we flew to Bermuda once, and I was sure we were going to die.
Because of the
Bermuda Triangle.
Because of the Bermuda Triangle.
Yeah, because I watched a show on it. We were going to Bermuda.
Oh, this is that.
This is not about the mirror. Oh, deadliest catch.
It's like everything that comes out of the ocean is going to kill you. It's deadly crabbing and deadly tuna-ing and deadly sword fishing and deadly sandcastle building.
Well, the ocean is
a dangerous place.
To be
respected. But do we really?
No, not until it's plastic. And we're reaping the.
Have you ever put bourbon in coffee? It's called a blackjack.
I probably have it one time in my life, yes.
I was just thinking because the
camping,
bar is right over there. And,
you know, camping. No, we're not going to start with the bourbon.
We're not. I'm not going to. I was just pointing out a culinary.
I was a little surprised you were not making a Bloody Mary, though, just because you could somehow justify it. Now I put the idea in your head. We don't even have a mix, I don't think.
Who says, who, do you know who I am? Mix.
We don't have tomatoes.
Either. Mix. We have canned tomatoes.
We do? Okay.
I can make a Bloody Mary out of nothing but an axe and a woman named Mary. See Bloody Mary? And your first name happens to actually be Mary. I wasn't thinking about that at the time I said it.
Believe me. Anyway.
But there are a lot of commercials.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's Tyler. Hey, Tyler. He doesn't like me.
These are the ones that I don't understand.
We're getting new benefits. We're not on Medicare.
I don't understand these big...
What?
These, like, big, cheap, like this... Oh, Joe Namath.
Wow.
He also lost weight.
He also lost weight. I think that's called dying. How old do you think Joe Namath is?
70?
Remember, like, in the 70s, he was... Remember the big fur coat that he would wear when he was on the sidelines?
I had a crush on him, and my dad... Who did he play for? New York, right?
Yeah, it was Jets.
Yeah, Jets. My dad did not like the TV show. I mean, I'm not awake yet. That team, and I would purposely root against teams that my dad didn't like.
This is why we have problems with parents. Well, Broadway Joe.
But I love Broadway Joe.
Good to see he's still working.
I have a big crush on him. I don't now.
You don't now?
No.
Oh, so you're an ageist.
No, I've grown into you. There's no room in my heart for anyone but you. It's true.
You've never stroked me like that in your entire life.
That's not true.
I know. All right. Commercials appear to almost be over.
Oh my gosh. How can they possibly... There's no time left for the show.
Well, technically...
I'm somehow fascinated by...
Well, let's see if they've cut the show down.
TV is big enough?
Because these are original Good Eats episodes, so they're 21 and a half minutes in actual length, and they're really hard to cut, so...
Look, you have your own books all lined up, like shameless advertisement.
I'm not advertising.
It's like all one, the same book.
It's about copyright. If I put other books up there, I have to be worried about getting art clearances on the backs and covers of the books. I don't have to worry about that with my own books.
Are those all the same books?
I think it was the only book I had out at the time.
2011? No.
They do look like they're all Good Eats.
The same.
Two.
Maybe you were selling them out of your kitchen window.
It's a thought. If I could sell, now see,
levitating.
I'm levitating. I'm on a dolly. I'm riding on the dolly.
I didn't know you could.
And then I'm going to go down. I can do all sorts of things as long as I have my key grip with me. I'm actually the one riding on the dolly. The camera is on another device. And I think that I'm going to go down when I take it with me. See, you don't see that every day.
No, but it's creepy because you're levitated.
Well, that should tell you something of my power.
I've never seen you levitate.
You've never asked me to levitate.
Right. It would have been helpful if you told me numerous times.
Well, if you need something from high up, I'd rather watch you go up a ladder.
Things you learn.
Ooh. Let's see if I actually...
fall?
Wait.
Speaking of heat management... I always fry.
Like you're in a scissor lift. Or something.
I'm on the camera dolly. I'm on the nose of the camera dolly. A lot of times we'll put me on the dolly instead of the camera on the dolly. Because it's fun and it allows you to do long shots like this way up in the pot rack. I miss not having coffee burps. I miss not having. No, turmeric burps. Is that making you belch?
No. It's healthy. Your body's like...
Look at that. Look at the organization.
And again, you've seen our house.
They haven't seen... That's a wine... That's actually a wine cooler.
I recognize.
But it's not our wine cooler.
No, it's not. And nor do you have all those oils.
I really like having a wine cooler down in the basement because when you think you're out of wine, you all of a sudden go, oh, wait, we've got a wine cooler. And you go down and there's stuff in it.
No, it's not like automatically filled.
You like the sideburns? You do?
Yeah, but you're also totally clean shaven.
I could be clean shaven again. Do you want me to do that?
Yeah, we talked about that. I like your whiskers. I like his whiskers.
She had to say why she likes my whiskers.
Because you scratch my back with them.
So there's too much information. Also, when it comes to people,
there's nobody watching.
That's true. It's too early. There's absolutely nobody on this thing. You're right. There's nobody.
How
it's
many
just
people
us.
Are there?
I don't know. I can't tell. Oh, 4,700.
Oh.
So shape up, will ya? Why is it you like my whiskers again?
I think they look great.
I have to get more coffee.
He's seem more, like, you're gonna leave me alone?
Yeah.
Like I might say
I'm
something.
I'm gonna let you talk more about scratching things with my whiskers.
I'm also getting all shine on my forehead. I don't know where that's, oh no, it's the X. Scabs is enjoying. Where's Scabs?
I gotta get something from the car.
Scabs watches TV.
What?
You're not going to the car.
You're supposed to be watching this episode. You've never seen it before.
Well, yeah, but I don't think they want to watch me watch the episode.
How do you know?
I pretty much guaranteed. He's pretty cute, though. I mean, on the TV show. And in person. Now, I have tried every possible. And I really should learn how to tempura. Hello. Why would I learn how to cook anything? Because he's yeah. around. Where's Franny?
Was in his chair,
probably.
Hello.
Hello. You've never. Oh, yeah, see, gluten is the problem.
She doesn't like gluten.
It doesn't like me.
I put a little evaporated milk in my coffee, but it's not doing it for me. I probably shouldn't have done that. We've used this gluten net, bungee net thing about 12,000 times, although now it's three-dimensional. We've built a three-dimensional cage that holds all the bungees, but every time I have to re-explain it.
We're going to minimize the gluten. That means using ingredients that minimize water and gluten and gliadin.
So tempura's got minimized gluten?
Yeah, because you don't want it. You want it crispy. You don't want it tough. A lot of tempuras are based on rice flour, and of course rice doesn't have wheat in it, so it doesn't have gluten.
That's why I eat rice. Instead of 10 ounces of
all-purpose flour, let's try 5 ounces each. Rice flour. Pay attention, you could learn something. Rice flour easily obtained in most mega markets and certain Asian markets contains no gluten-forming molecules. I'm glad we don't have to do this for, well, this marathon runs till 1:30 in the afternoon, so that's 8 episodes.
Well, let's consider
yeah.
I wonder what the other shows are going to be. Does anybody have the right list? No, I don't have my own flour brand, but we have to Greek the packages.
I know.
The whole thing about Greeking packages is that you can't.
Why is it called Greeking?
Well, because that actually comes out of publishing. When big blocks of dialogue, if you didn't have the dialogue or you didn't have the copy yet, but you were showing where copy was going to go, you would use just all mixed up letters that look like it's all Greek to me.
Okay.
And so that turned into making up fake labels or covering up labels on packages so that you get around the legalities of showing them. And it's not always the legality of copyright or trademark. A lot of times it's the fact that the brand might be different from somebody who sponsors the program. It gets messy. Well, maybe it's time for more.
Oh my God.
Right, more commercials.
My turn.
Where are you going?
To go get more turmeric. That has to make some toast.
You're going to make toast out of what? We don't have any bread. Oh, I hate gluten-free toast. I don't like gluten-free toast. Scabs, do you want to talk to the people? Scabs. Scabigail Van Buren. Rescue dog. Rescued from a dog hoarding operation. She weighed about half this when we got her. She has a blue eye, for those that don't know. She's not our only dog. She's just the clingy one. The other one's hiding in his chair. Oh, no. Francis is on Mr. Puff. Scabs likes to watch TV, though. She especially likes to bark at horses. What? Do we have bread? You know what I'd like? I'd like a piece of toast with a little cream cheese and some of that lox on it. Do we still have lox?
Yeah.
So we got some lox and whitefish salad shipped in from... Hey, remember the other night when I showed you our freezer?
Ah! You know what? Look,
it's terrible.
I have other...
What?
Bread, but I'm going to lose. It's particularly bad because if you're freezing, you don't have to stop.
We're gonna eat that?
No, I suppose I had.
Wait, look in the door.
I know you've got that, but I also
bread.
I had mine, but I don't know where it is now. We've also been doing a lot of takeout.
We have been doing a lot of takeout.
Which is what I'll.
We've been doing a lot of takeout because we want to support the restaurants that are doing it. There's pita bread.
I don't eat pita bread. No,
that's
got gluten in it.
It has gluten in it.
I don't know where my bread is.
Well, you're just gluten out of luck.
No, I don't. This is gluten free, but I had another.
Where did it go?
I don't know.
I did not do something with your gluten-free bread.
You did.
I sure as hell didn't eat it. Well, we know that. Francis?
I'm not worried about.
He did it. Francis ate the gluten-free bread.
Yeah.
Look at him. Look at that face.
Yeah, he looks so good.
Ooh, Good Eats is back on. Oh. Hope you guys are enjoying this. Beginning of the marathon. Are you going to come back and watch this? Or have you already drifted away out of lack of interest? I'm about to do something fascinating. I'm using seltzer water. Vinegar. So why would I put vinegar? That would lower the pH. That's not the right thing. That I don't want to lower the pH. Scabs isn't into it. How are you guys doing this morning? I'm pretty excited. Alcohol. Of gluten. That's the big thing. That's why just even a little bit of vodka Antura makes a lot of difference because of not creating gluten. Liquid without gluten. I mean, liquid without water. Or you know, 40% alcohol by volume. No. It's not about fermentation. It's about the fact that that alcohol like vodka isn't all water. You've got methyl alcohol in there, 40% by volume, typically, and that doesn't create gluten. It doesn't react with gliadin and glutenin. She's saying that if you're wondering, I really do talk like that on a regular basis, but not to a point of being that irritating. By the way, if you're a Good Eats fan, I just want to say that the season of Reloaded that's about to start on Cooking Channel are like the best Good Eats episodes we've ever made. They're 70% new, and they're really good. And I don't think I've ever said that about my own shows before. I was really skinny and boyish. I still look really young. I wonder what's aged me. Mowage. Might be the alcohol. Well, I think I look good for 57. You're quite pleased with your choice. I'm insured. This show's kind of boring when I think about it. I don't think I ever saw this show after it got scored. I've never seen this with the music. I'm not a fan.
Here we go. And make sure you put them in one at a time.
It's a little bossy.
So they don't touch. Heat management here is key, so check the thermometer off.
So now we use a rig that keeps the camera directly over the food. We kind of invented that, by the way, that whole camera right over the food thing. We did that first on Good Eats. Anyway, steam is always an issue. So now we've actually mounted little computer fans. I was against it, by the way. I thought it was stupid. But my key grip and my cameraman came up with a system of little fans that blow across an optical flat in front of the lens, and it actually works really well. They were right; I was wrong. But I was smart enough to hire them, so that still reflects well on me. Tempura is harder than this. This is why in Japan, you know, there are restaurants that they don't do anything but tempura. In fact, I've been to a restaurant in Japan that it didn't just do tempura, but it only did like specific types of tempura. That's how picky that stuff is. Hey, we're up to 5,000 people. As soon as you went into the kitchen, we got another 1,000 people. I'm kidding. They want you. They like you better than they like me. The quarantine kitchen crowd prefers you to me. Because they're waiting for you to come back, sweetheart. Are you making toast? You don't have to do that for me. We're watching Good Eats. You're missing this episode. Into the ginger sauce. Oh, bother. According to legend, the shogun Tokugawa, should have liked tempura so much he ate it to death in 1616. Commercials. Deadliest Catch commercial. Ooh. The Russians are coming.
Not the Nazis?
Not the Nazis. That's more History Channel, sweetheart. There aren't nearly as many Nazis on Science Channel. This is Capital One, where you can open a news. I think that bringing Russians into Deadliest Catch is a good idea. What? Ooh, we would do a show about Deadliest Catch, but it would be caviar. It's our one, it's the only food that Elizabeth and I would steal, probably. We're caviar fanatics. We don't get it very often, because your birthday. You get all you, well, not all you can eat, because we can't afford that. But yeah, caviar. So we could do a Deadliest Catch. It would be like about shoplifting caviar. We would never do that. Cate Blanchett's on TV, honey. It's that American woman on FX. Oh, look, it's the Medicare coverage helpline again. So this is the kind of advertising we get at this time of the morning. There's something about Good Eats that apparently is very big with the Medicare. Oh, Joe Namath's back. Yeah, Joe Namath called the Medicare hotline. I don't think so. No. He's got either people to do that or he doesn't need it because he invested very well during the 80s. There's an actual school you go to, this training stuff, this media training, where they teach you how to use your hands up in the frame like that, because nobody ever really actually talks like that, the way that he's doing that. Nobody really does that. It's not natural. I'm gonna write down this number. We can call to speak to a licensed insurance agent. Alex Garnaschelli's on. I love her. I love Alex Garnaschelli. And you do too. I didn't mean I love her in a way that... You don't share. You're not... You don't share.
Our soy ginger tempura sauce begins with ginger marmalade. Only 2 tablespoons freshly grated.
I'm finally waking up. That's about 200 milliliters of my 400 milliliter morning dose.
Next, we need 2 tablespoons also of green onion. I like to use just the first 4 inches.
Notice how, okay, he keeps his knuckles back. That's important when cutting. You know, that's how you cut your fingers off. That's how you don't cut your fingers off.
1 teaspoon of sesame oil, 1/4 cup of rice wine vinegar.
OXO makes those cups that have that kind of measurement that you can look straight down and see, but that stuff like washes off after about 100 washings. OXO, you need to get on that because it's a good design, but if all the numbers fall off and you can't see anything, then what the hell good is it?
You should slip off and cook the seafood while your guests stay behind and talk about what a genius.
I think the show's almost over. Oh no, we're making another batch of tempura. This cooking show has too much cooking in it. Tilapia is an interesting fish. A lot of people don't like tilapia because it's a mild flavor. What? You've heard that tilapia is trash? Here's the thing. Tilapia has an amazing food body weight ratio. It's like for every half pound of food they eat, they put on a pound of weight. So they're very, very sustainable and they eat things most people wouldn't want to eat. They're not vegetarians, but they can be vegetarians. Anyway, they've got a high feed conversion rate. That's what it's called, high feed conversion rate. So they're very sustainable, and they can be farmed, raised in aquaculture without any real problems for the environment. And for people that don't actually like fish, tilapia is a pretty good fish. I like tilapia tacos a lot. See, it's already over. This was not a very entertaining show. He's not a very good host. Yeah, it's Good Eats too. I've got like 7 of them lined up on the counter.
At the last minute.
Everything outside that window. They quarter screened the end scene. Who do they think they are? They're rolling right into another episode. I don't know what I don't even know what this is. Do you want us to stick around for one more episode? I mean, we will if you want. This is like, we're not going anywhere. I have to write Good Eats episodes today, but I don't even know what this is. You did. I am still skinny as you. Oh, thank you. So you brought yourself some marmalade and she. Oh, squash. It's a squash show. I'd rather have this yummy blocked.
But I give you something to eat the rest of it.
By the way, oh, now the dogs are interested. Zucker's in New York. Synthesis, thank you. We're almost out. That's all I'm going to say. We've been out of whitefish salad for days.
I don't know which one. You bought two, or you got two that they sent to, whatever.
It's their Nova.
That's the Nova?
Zucker's does.
So good.
Awesome Nova. I think it comes from...
Because one was thinner than the other. A little
really?
Saltier. This is less...
It's the whitefish salad you only want.
I don't know.
This is a strange experience.
The toast?
No. This whole meta thing of sitting here at home, watching old Good Eats episodes while talking to people on YouTube about old Good Eats episodes.
We're growing squash.
What?
We're growing squash.
We are growing squash. Do you have a favorite squash out there? I have. These are all soft squashes, I guess. Oh, no, they're not. Different sizes. This one, check that out. Oh, we're doing hard ones too.
I used to do butternut. That is a new hybrid actually cross between the yellow crookneck and the Delicata squash, which is actually a winter. You gotta be careful when you grow them because they take over a garden. Berries, seed bearing
bodies. You know that squash is part of the three sisters, the Native Indians, Native Americans, the
corn,
squash, and beans. Provides a complete protein.
I'm not sure about that shirt, sure, baby. A squash, which is Algonquin for eaten. I always beat him at Scrabble. That's not true. Not always.
I am the worst Scrabble player on earth. I play words like cat.
No, that's why I beat you once, is that I did all like three-letter words, but I somehow...
I can't think of any words when I play Scrabble. I have a prop department. Todd Bailey, Paul Merchant, ladies and gentlemen. And this has got a hatch in it.
Who's that?
Some kid. It's James and the Giant Peach. It's a riff.
I don't know who the kid was.
I don't know.
What's it made of?
Excellent. That would be polystyrene. Styrofoam. Giant styrofoam squash. You don't see that on anywhere, really. I don't know who the kid is. Oh, wait. No, I don't know. When it comes to storage, tender little squashes are like time bombs. The clock is ticking away. I mean, sure, if you wrap them in paper towels. What's your problem with the shirt? It's summer.
You don't have it now.
I still have that shirt. I just can't wear it because I'm too fat. You'll get
only 3 days. I could wear like a dress.
If you'd like, I'll bring it from the warehouse. I know where it is.
I don't think it's me.
So, you'll notice the black dot on the milk container. Our joke on set is, is we call it Black Dot brand. It is actually Publix brand, but Publix has got the easiest packages to Greek. All we have to do is cover up the little Publix with a black dot, and it becomes Black Dot brand. Still using Steadicam at this point, as you can see. What's that?
You're mad at them right now.
No, I'm not. Let's not say that. 5.3 thousand people have nothing better to do but watch us eat toast and watch old Good Eats episodes. That's what a quarantine will do. That's what. Sorry, I kind of cut you out there. The purging of squash is really important. It can make huge differences to the overall texture, just pulling out some moisture.
Let's say for a moment that this is a...
Ooh, it's a science model.
Fresh from the garden. Yeah, I know it's just a stack of boxes. Okay, now, in its fresh state, it is stiff, what plant people call...
I have no memory of doing this.
Why? Well, the cell walls are certainly...
I'm learning things,
though. ...stiff structures, but the real secret is inside here. So if you cut away the cell wall, you'll see that the cells are full of little bags, right? It's called a cell membrane. It's packed.
Look at that.
The cell needs to...
That's very cool. Business. That you didn't cut through the bottom of the bag, too.
All right. Now,
I've got skills.
With our salt, okay? And the salt resolves into a brine, which will literally pull moisture.
I don't think there's anything wrong with that shirt.
Osmotic pressure.
As long as you don't wear it, it's fine.
As long as I don't wear it?
Now, it's only a matter of time before that...
Is there a big bucket down there?
It's in a kiddie pool. The whole thing's in a kiddie pool. Buckets never really catch what you think they're going to catch. You've got to have a kiddie pool. Oh, look. Half of that set decorating is actually on our shelves here now.
If managed properly, this will result not in...
This is all in one shot, by the way, if you notice that.
Well, floppy structure, kind of like... Well,
look at all the Good Eats books.
The same ones.
I was clearly pushing Good Eats 2 at the time.
Okay, they're so green, but they look like noodles.
I'm going to wait. I want more coffee, but I'm going to wait for the commercial, and there's going to be one any minute. I can sense it. Actually, Act 1 should have been about 7 minutes, if I remember correctly, back then. Same season, because I'm still wearing the Breitling Aerospace. Breitling.
Is he making noodles? Zucchini noodles?
I'm making zucchini noodles. Yes. That's like a tossed salad.
Right.
Half a small red onion sliced.
You would eat this.
A cup of torn...
No, you don't like onions. That you don't like red onions.
You just... I would have eaten it about a minute ago. I'm not that picky at all.
No, No. I am not portraying you as a picky eater. But you're not big on red onions. And you don't like... she refuses to eat eggplant. Texture. You don't like stewed tomatoes, and you hate okra.
Right. It's all texture.
Texture.
Yeah. Although Indian food, like, they basically fry the crap out of those. Okra.
So if they fry okra, it's okay. Got it.
Like, really fried. Diminutive.
Maybe this will be another commercial for...
This is a place that...
Something
ooh.
Constricts and suffocates the soul.
Yikes. Constricts and suffocates the soul.
So it's about ghosts. Well, that's science-y now, isn't it? I'm going to get some more coffee. Do you want anything, sweetheart? Do you want anything?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
But we're only going to...
Scabs, what do you think?
Scabs thinks it's silly for science to have ghosts.
When Franny was...
It's completely unscientific. I've heard that.
Neglected. Abandoned. Mysteries of the Abandoned.
That's complete BS.
That's all new Detroit.
No.
There's some really cool spaces on here, though.
Yeah, but I don't like the whole trying to make it look supernatural with the signs.
They're not, I don't think they're saying that.
No?
No, that's the travel, no, now it's the ghost channel.
Oh, is that an after travel channel?
Histories of the
abandoned.
No, they're not saying that. It's just cool. I have a thing for architecture, because I studied architecture. Buildings. Huh? I don't know. Oh, Tina Fey and the funny guy, Mayhem, is on.
Is that who that is?
Mayhem? I don't know. I really...
Yeah, it's Tina Fey.
And Mayhem guy.
I want to be Mayhem.
You
I could
Mayhem.
Do Mayhem.
So
no,
could do Mayhem.
I could... I wanted to be Mayhem for Halloween one year.
If The Incredibles ever became like a live thing, you could be.
Choose your next words. Ever
I don't
so
know
wise.
His name. The villain.
Which villain? From which one?
Oh, not The Incredibles. Despicable Me. You could be the Despicable Me guy.
Gru. Guy's name? Gru. I think Steve Carell would be upset about that.
And I'm going to say the live
version. Oh, in a live version. Because I would never be the hero. I would only be the villain.
But he is the hero. He's got the little kid. He's both. You're both.
The first thing that I would do is I would make a dip out of minions. Like hummus.
Onion. Onion dip. Except you're confusing minion dip.
Minion dip. I would make minion dip. Be like, what are these little yellow bits? These are pieces of minion.
Minion dip. Got it. Oh, this is the what to do with quarantine.
This is how entertainment dies.
Oh, that's what's his name. I didn't know who was still doing.
Who was it? I didn't see who it was.
The mini jobs guy. I had like all the mini jobs.
Oh, you mean dirty jobs?
Dirty jobs.
I can't think of his name. That's terrible.
Tom?
No. Oh, Mike Rowe. It's Mike Rowe. I remembered it. No, I didn't. I read it.
I didn't even have it.
Oh. I'm learning how to read things off the phone. Okay, all right. Mike Rowe. Yeah, we get it. Mike Rowe. Quit typing. Mike Rowe. I forgot how to say Mike Rowe. Give me
Mike
a break.
Never met him.
Harry's a really nice guy.
He's usually like, oh, I met him. Oh, I know him. Oh, I hung out with him. I knew him.
No, I've never met him. Okay. Never met him. Greetings from Alaska. Somebody's known from Alaska.
Why
where in Alaska? Well, there might be a bear. There could be
fishing, or that's Minnesota.
This time of year, it may already be light.
Is it light? Alaska.
Our Alaska person. Yes, I saw Adam Savage was there. Good guy, Adam. I haven't seen him in a few years. He's staying so busy right now, and he's a big-time star. He's like, big-time stars hang out with other big-time stars. So if you're whoever the person was in Alaska, do me a favor and tell him. Oh, hello from the Netherlands.
Hi.
We love the
Netherlands.
Hi, Alaska,
too. We went to Amsterdam. Hello from Hong Kong.
We love Amsterdam. It's one of our favorite, our favorite
city.
And
cities. I adore Hong Kong. He's never been to Hong Kong.
The only place in Asia I've ever been is Japan.
Yeah.
I hear it's the prices are good right now.
If you can get there.
We should have to row a boat. Hop a flight to Wuhan. We could probably fly first class.
They're not letting us in.
They're not letting us in. Or they'll let us in, but they won't let us back.
No, I think they're not letting us in.
No, they're not letting us in. Anyway, this is more fun now. Oh, Australia. Hey, guys.
Wow.
I didn't.
Yeah, you did. That's a different shirt. It's a different shirt.
How's that shirt?
It's pink. I don't know. I'm not a fan.
You know why? The Hawaiian shirts, though. I've told you this. So the reason there were Hawaiian shirts on so many Good Eats episodes is that they're traditionally made out of rayon. And rayon is much more microphone friendly than a lot of other fabrics. Yeah, it doesn't do that. So I've got microphones hidden in the placards, and they're easier to do. These people are more interesting. South Africa is on right now. Michigan, Scotland. Your giant heed. I can't do that accent. Is the haggis show? Alabama, we like Alabama. We actually spend a fair amount of time there. Rochester, New York, Virginia. Elton John is on Good Eats.
What?
That's somebody said. Traverse City, Tennessee, Connecticut, Kansas. Hello from Cleveland, Ohio. Hi, Cleveland. It's nice to see you all guys out. Good evening from Japan.
Wow.
We love Japan. Oxford, Mississippi, Columbus, Georgia, New York City.
Now I'm getting nervous.
Marietta, Austin, Texas, Canada A, Toronto, Indiana, Syracuse, Savannah, Georgia, New Jersey.
Is everyone
Chicago,
in lockdown?
Chicago, Pakistan. Are you guys all on lockdown? They must be.
Lockdown?
Why would they be watching us and doing this? Pittsburgh, PA, Wales.
I love Wales.
Wales. No. Without the H.
I love both Wales.
The villages down in Florida, Arlington, Maryland, Clayton, Georgia.
The Villages was very much in the news recently, wasn't it?
Yeah, they had the highest incident of
STD. So you're okay?
I thought it was the whole STD thing. Didn't the Villages have like more STD than anywhere else in the nation because those old folks get around? That's what I heard. Finland. How are things in Finland? Are you guys locked up?
There's the Sweden thing and there's the Denmark thing. There's like a experiment that's happening there where Sweden's letting it go and Denmark's locking it down. Well, I don't know what Finland's
Sweden
doing.
Is counting on the common sense of their people.
Which is called herd mentality.
Lucky Yates. Love that guy to death. Of course, he is Dr. Krieger on Archer on FX.
Why is he all messed up?
Because he's a safety officer. It's a riff on that character that Jim Carrey used to play on in Living Color, the fire marshal.
Right.
We've got Iowa on the line. We've got New Hampshire, Canada. Oh, you guys have been locked down since March 16th. Wow.
Canada?
I think that was Canada. Stuttgart, Germany. We have a car from Stuttgart.
We do.
The Mercedes.
Yeah.
Rhode Island. Boston.
In the house. I'm not going to swear.
You're not going to cuss.
Too swearing.
You're not going to go all Ben Affleck on us? Okay, great. Bass players. Tell me about bass players.
I'm learning. By.
Well, they can see that. They can see your stingray. People were asking about if that was a Music Man short scale, and it is. Could we watch you write a GE episode? Oh, crap, you wouldn't want to see that. To watch me write a Good Eats episode?
No,
you don't want to see that. There's a lot.
No, that would be, that's not PG-13. Ooh. That is rated R.
Sometimes worse.
Have to be.
No, you don't want that.
No.
Certainly not.
He puts
no lockdown in Taiwan.
Really? No lockdown in Taiwan? I thought you guys, well, I know that they've had a really good
Los Angeles. I know they're locked down in Los Angeles.
Yeah, we know that.
Yes. I'm down to watch AB get naked.
No. Yes. I mean, but no.
There's no bouncing back from that, sweetheart.
I think we need to.
Don't tell me what I want. France, New Orleans. I'm distracting you from your work. I'm sorry. Text. What? I'm distracting myself from my own cooking.
That looks yummy.
I have no memories of this.
I know you never make it, so you've forgotten.
You don't like summer squash.
I don't mind it. I like cruciferous better. But I like squash.
She likes cruciferous.
But
Georgia and Florida, your producer, summer squash in the U.S. People don't eat enough of it. They grow it, and then it goes bad. Let's see. Lake Charles, Chattanooga, Tennessee, Chicago, New Zealand. Hey, New Zealand, why are you up? Why would you guys even be awake?
It's like tomorrow there.
Any good ideas for spaghetti squash? Yeah, I think that we have some of those in the show. Minneapolis. Will you do Cutthroat Kitchen again? No, because they haven't asked me to do it.
We could do
San Francisco.
Our own
we could do our own
Cutthroat. At our lake house. We could do Camp Cutthroat.
We can do camp. It's not a lake house. It has one room. It's a cabin.
It's a lake shack.
It's a shack.
Really
we have a
shack.
Lake. We have a lake shack.
Plywood lake shack.
We have a plywood lake shack, and it's gorgeous. She designed it. Michigan, Louisville. Hi, guys. Oh, it's another commercial.
Yeah, let's all stop and watch the commercials.
We need to watch. The commercials are important. Look, do you think that your cable bill even begins to cover programming? It doesn't. That's just the money that the cable people keep and pays for the upkeep of the system. The programming is paid for by commercials.
So, who FX is advertising on science? Is that because they're owned by the same
that's
people?
That's that. Nope. That's called cross advertising. A lot of people advertise like that. It doesn't mean you don't just advertise what's on your network. You give them money.
I see it, but I get confused.
Street Outlaws, Memphis on Discovery.
I've never understood this whole cop, like, outlaw thing. See, this is the abandoned stuff. Oh, no, wait. I don't know.
I like the graphics.
I'm a little bit...
Mysteries of the Abandoned.
You think our TV's big enough?
No.
We don't watch a lot of movies, is why.
This TV is...
Movies are great.
It is large.
Advertisements this large are disturbing.
Wait.
You've already written the number down like 12 times. You're fine. I know. I've seen him. I'm done now. I've had my memories.
I'm not drinking Maxwell House. I'm noticing you with all the hearts, but it went by very quickly. Portland, Maine. Rhode Island again. Hold on. I have to touch this to make it stop, don't I? Yes, the TV is big enough. Oh, wait. Do you have plans? Wait. Have plans to... our tour plans. Right now, at this point, Alton Brown Live Beyond the Eats is scheduled to launch on the road in November. We're still on. We're going to open in Minneapolis. Could it change?
Sure, everything could change, but at this point in time, we're betting and banking on reality adjusting itself a little bit more to our liking. So that tour will be announced in June, by the way, and we'll be traveling, also touring in the spring of next year, maybe the fall.
On the bus with the dogs.
Look, Nazis.
They're trying to make Nazis sexy.
Forbidden history.
Nazis aren't sexy, they just have good
uniforms.
No, they're
not sexy, but we did watch JoJo.
We did watch JoJo.
Can we recommend
Rabbit.
JoJo?
I don't know that, you know, people are, yes. I think JoJo
Rabbit
was the best movie of last year.
Really great, really great movie.
I thought Scarlett Johansson was wonderful. I think
I'm not
going to
say
was amazing.
That Tahiti Waititi made.
We can't even say his name right.
No, I know. But I think he's such a great director. Anyway.
He is a very good director.
He made Hitler.
But he also made
testable.
What We Do in the Shadows, my favorite comedy
coming
movie
up on the 15th.
Of my life, and the second season of the TV show starting on the 15th on
FX.
Is it on FX? It is FX. That's our favorite TV
yeah,
show.
Yeah, on FX.
That TV show.
But you know, you can
wait,
also.
Hold on. This person keeps. Hold on. Notice me. You're a huge part of my childhood and why I became a cook. Let me be a part of Camp Cutthroat. We don't make camp. Oh, you mean the new Camp Cutthroat? We can't actually call it that because we don't own the copyright.
What are we going to do? We could do.
Crap. What I just do?
I don't know.
Okay, I'm still learning how to use this. We're only going to stay on a few more minutes because you guys have to get on with your day. AB, how can your international audience support Good Eats? Well, that's a really, really good question. I would say that the number one thing that you could do is support our YouTube channel right now and watching Quarantine Kitchen. That actually is a huge amount of support, and we pay attention to it.
But also, they did put the first reloads on YouTube, right?
Well, what they're doing is the first episode of the new season is on the cooking channel.
Is it cooking channel?
YouTube. I don't know if it's on food.
It's
networks.
On YouTube, though. They can
yes,
Google.
But only one of them. Only
I mean,
one
they
episode.
Could search. I know.
And then you can watch all of the reloads on the app, on what's called Food Network Go. But it's behind what we call the paywall, which means, but you know,
well, support. They ask about support.
You think TVs that big by themselves? That probably wasn't the way to put that. We have to get paid too. Yeah, you got to get on with your day. Stay well. I know you guys are all probably going to have to go here soon, and we are too. What are we eating this weekend? Somebody's asking what we're eating this weekend. We are getting our Easter.
Oh yeah, Easter dinner.
Dinner is actually coming. It's Easter.
Oh, I'm
from
gonna do,
a local.
Eggs. Easter eggs.
You're gonna do Easter eggs. We're gonna make Easter eggs. Mm-hmm. What are we gonna dye them with?
I'm sure there's dye at the office.
There's not dye at the
turmeric.
Office.
Turmeric. Lots of turmeric. Lots of yellow eggs.
We can do it from like berries or something.
We'll forage in the forest.
Anyway, so we're getting our Easter dinner from a restaurant here in Marietta called The Butcher, The Baker, who's of course closed to the public, but doing dinners for pickup, which is something that you might think about in your area in order to keep. Somebody brought up feasting on asphalt. That's never a good subject. I don't want to talk about that. I get very angry when we talk about feasting on asphalt. No reason to get further into that. Okay, that lady in the back is that's Mandy. That's Amanda Kibler, our costume person. That. That's Jim Pace, my longtime associate and drummer on the tour. Every crew member who works on Good Eats has to be in Good Eats. It's the rule. Native Americans learn to grow them together, not only because they represent a complete protein when served together. Oh, V-Master.
V-Master.
Wait. Agricultural community.
Traditionally, the crop first. That was slick.
But get this, this is wrong. They don't move that way, they move the other way. This is a good time to answer a question. Have a great day. You too. Hi, San Antonio. Hi, New Jersey. What are the stabby things under the TV? Those are here. So in Europe, engineering students, at least it used to be, engineering students would have to turn metal on a lathe. It was part of, I don't know why. And so a lot of them chose to do models of transmission towers, TV or radio transmission towers. I don't know which city this one was from. So we found.
We have a book on it.
We do have a book on it. So we found, we were in
Palm
Springs.
our first New Year's together, and we found this entire collection. Some of them are souvenirs, but most of them are handmade by engineering students in Europe. And so all these are radio transmission tower models, and some of them are heavy as freaking really, really heavy.
Yeah, they have
some
to learn. It's like
they have to learn how to turn
tradesmen.
Yeah. Trade school stuff.
And they have to learn how to turn on a lathe. So and
why they would have to do that for engineering school, I don't know. But this is, I don't know that this one. Do you think that's handmade or do you think that's, that looks awfully sophisticated.
Well,
anyway, that's what they are.
No.
We're real fans of that kind of stuff. And the fact that we found them in a collection was pretty good.
Yeah.
Other things. Oh, there's going to be another commercial. Okay, so I can show some other stuff. Okay, so Peter Tony, who's a New York artist, bought a bunch of paintings that came out of the Trump, what was the one in Atlantic City? Was that the Taj Mahal?
Taj Mahal.
Hotel, and then like added things to them. So it's like a pastoral landscape, and then he put a nuclear explosion on the horizon. That's technically Castle Bravo, which was a big nuclear test. So we have that. I don't know why I bring
very
that up.
Very cheery.
Well, there's nothing like looking out
it's
at
very,
a pastoral landscape
prescient.
And seeing.
That's,
well, no, maybe.
Prescient. Yeah.
See, that's our. Those are shelves.
Right,
we're in complete mess mode. That's a big neon light that came out of a old something. Yeah. Stereo bar.
Yeah.
Coffee table. We don't. We're not being very neat these days. I'm not going to lie about it.
Is anyone being neat these days?
I don't know that anybody's being neat, but we have to keep some sense of order or else things start to fall apart. So we're only going to be on a few more minutes because we've got, yes, it is a tube amp. Rogue Audio. It's the Cronus 2, I think. We like tubes.
We love it.
We actually, it's funny, we've gone back to CDs big time. I'm a big vinyl fan, but then we got ourselves a decent CD player because Elizabeth had a bunch of CDs.
I have vinyl too, but it got to be a pain where we had to turn it over every 30 minutes.
You like, have to turn them over. There's music on the second side. On a CD, they put it all on one side. It's pretty amazing. So we listen to a lot.
We have a really great CD player, though. It makes a big difference.
Where are the pups? The pups are here. Scabs is resting on Mr. Puff. There she is. And Francis is over on his chair, which is another piece of furniture.
Yeah.
And there's more dangerous fishing going on. Okay, there are no questions. Nobody has any questions, right? Oh, there they are. Crap, there they are. Hold on. There's an engineering student from Georgia Tech in Atlanta. If I make one of those transmission towers, would you accept it? Absolutely.
Yeah.
We would love to add more transmission towers to our collection. Gosh, yes, absolutely. We would love that. Thank you very much. That's a wonderful thing.
You're a big fan.
Okay, hold on. Montpelier, Vermont. Hi, Montpelier, Vermont. Sorry about what happened to New England Culinary Institute. I don't even know what to say about
like
that.
Chefs just there wandering the
micro,
street.
Micro. Adam Savage, Guy Fieri. And I shot mine yesterday.
Oh, did you? Oh,
but I'm the only person that's going to be in a bathrobe. They all got dressed.
Oh, that's that one.
But they all look funny because they don't have their makeup on. Since I don't use makeup when I shoot, I look exactly the same. So I'm actually going to look better than they all do. Because they
it's
didn't have their makeup.
It's not a competition. It's not a beauty contest.
Everything's a competition. Everything's a competition. Okay.
But
okay, that feels good. Stop. Globes in the kitchen. What about the globes in the kitchen? Yes, we have a lot of globes. We have lots and lots of globes. I need a $100 hamburger in my 172. That is a pilot talking. A $100 hamburger is a meal, usually a hamburger, that one gets in one's airplane to fly to, and it's called $100 because it costs $100 even to crank an airplane these days, and a 172 is a Cessna Skyhawk. Try the ones over at, if you're local, on the field at Gwinnett used to have a really good.
Also DeKalb Airport.
Petri DeKalb is famous for theirs, but I also like the one at Gwinnett.
There's one in L.A. There's like a small grill in the, I don't know what field it is. LA.
It's not
Van
a Hawthorne. It's El Van Nuys.
There.
Yeah, that would be a $200 burger. Or if you live in Atlanta, that would be a $4,000 burger.
Yeah.
Unless you have a jet, and then it'd be a $10,000 burger.
Got it.
I don't fly anymore. Are you planning on doing a stop in New Orleans on the tour? That'll be in the spring. Would I use a Damascus steel knife if I ever got one? Of course I would. The problem with Damascus, they're very pretty, but they tend to have, very often, the different metals involved will have different corrosive
properties, or meaning that they don't always stand up to kitchen environments very well. So you have to be careful with the way that you handle them. How do you like Mama's Boy in Athens? Do you know Mama's Boy? We were just in Athens, and
like the Manhattan Cafe, we took you there.
What are my thoughts on Santoku knives? I like Santokus a lot. I'm more of a Western knife fan, but the shape of a Santoku, I've got a couple of Santokus. It's a good shape, and it's a good general shape if you're gonna only, do I watch Tiger King? No, I don't. We haven't done that. There's too many people watching it, I don't think I wanna watch it. Do you like Cincinnati style chili?
I do.
No.
I do a lot.
Oh, we have to go now. It's another episode. You're gonna complain about that shirt too?
No, I like that one.
A maelstrom of mediocrity.
Maelstrom.
A maelstrom of mediocrity.
I like Cincinnati chili.
I don't.
He doesn't.
Nope.
I don't know why.
Don't like it. It's crap.
I like Grater's.
It's crap.
Too.
I like Cincinnati. What?
Grater's ice cream.
Well, you didn't.
And Arnold's.
Well, those
I
are
lived
wonderful.
There for a few months.
Cincinnati is great. What do they call the other side of the river, the cool
over
side?
Over the Rhine.
Rhine.
Over no. Over the Rhine is part of it, but it's the Kentucky side. I forget what it's called. Sorry, I'm sure they're telling you.
Dead children.
Oh, dead children. Okay. On that note,
I had to make my own family back then.
No, you had your family.
It's like what? Bye. Oh, this is where we try to figure out how to turn this
like
thing
everybody's
off.
Doing the same
I never
thing.
Know how to turn this off.
There you go.
Bye.
Bye.
We'll answer questions. If you keep sending questions, we'll answer them online.